Greetings from JPMorgan's 37th Annual Healthcare Conference. My name is Harlan Sur. I'm the semiconductor capital equipment analyst here for the firm. For the first time in the history of the healthcare conference, we have a semiconductor company presenting, Nvidia, a leader in visual and computing silicon and systems. Joining us here today from Nvidia is Kimberly Powell, Vice President for Healthcare at Nvidia. Thank you for joining us today, Kimberly.
Thank you. It's a real honor to be here.
Great. Thank you. The first question that I want to ask, which is a high-level question, which is, why did the Nvidia team make the decision to participate in our healthcare conference this year?
Well, Harlan, we've been working in healthcare for over 10 years. We've been heavily focused in medical imaging and life sciences and drug discovery. And with the real burgeoning artificial intelligence community, what we've seen is the last five, 6 years, the research community in all facets of healthcare have really embraced artificial intelligence. And we're seeing this make its way into all of the different practices of healthcare. Everything from, you know, reinventing how we're doing genomics and drug discovery to the clinical care process, and even getting now into preventative care and all of the different sensors that are entering this space. So as an AI computing company, it seemed like a, you know, a perfect time for us to come talk to this community, connect with all of the leaders here. I mean, everyone in the industry is here. You know, startups are here, large companies are here, the provider space is here, the payer space is here. And with artificial intelligence, it's the time to connect with all of these parts of the ecosystem in healthcare and really enable them to get on this AI track.
You know, for a leader like Nvidia in the technology space, you know, and focusing on healthcare, you know, from your perspective, what are some of the important technology transformations that are happening in healthcare? More importantly, how is Nvidia set up to take advantage of those technology inflections?
Yeah, sure. If you look at just in the last 5 years, new devices and instruments are entering the marketplace that are allowing for new capabilities. You wouldn't say that genomics was sort of mainstream 5 years ago. But today, I think it's going pretty mainstream. It's becoming part of the clinical care process. You're seeing new genomics devices that are being held in the palm of your hand and democratizing the ability to do genomics. You see new instruments for drug discovery, like electron microscopy that won the Nobel Prize, allowing us to see the structure of proteins we were never able to see before. And if you just look at it from the perspective of these are the instruments that are going to drive the journey towards precision medicine. And if you think about how difficult and complex the data that they're generating, the size that it is, and the fact that, you know, biology is one of our biggest, you know, data challenges, this is the time that artificial intelligence and Nvidia as an AI computing company can make the contribution to the entire pipeline from the acquisition of this data to the analysis of this data and all the way into the integration of the data to really, really find our way towards more and more precision medicine technologies.
Yeah, and the one thing that I've always appreciated about Nvidia and Jensen, the CEO and founder of Nvidia, is that he's always very forward-thinking, always thinking about the next 5 to 10 years. And so as you think about your healthcare leadership and your healthcare franchise, thinking out longer term over the next 5 to 10 years, what are you most excited about? What do you think is going to be that next big inflection point for your franchise looking out to that time period?
Yeah, sure. The radiology industry is kind of on the short term. We hit an inflection point in 2018. We're seeing hundreds of AI applications enter the medical imaging space, and it's affecting everything from the operations of the radiology practice to the diagnostics of the practice to even doing things we were never able to do before, like detect biomarkers through the images. So radiology is absolutely going to be one of the fastest moving adopters of artificial intelligence, and it's going to transform that entire industry. And that's going to affect patients and clinical and the providers. So that space is really going to benefit rapidly. Some of the other areas that I think are incredibly interesting is absolutely drug discovery. We just talked about new instruments, new amounts of data, and we know that there is a challenge, a major, major challenge in drug discovery and the time that it takes and the cost that it takes to introduce drugs to the market. So being able to employ high-performance computing, accelerated computing, and AI technologies to start doing things more in silico than it is always done, you know, in the wet lab to accelerate that process all the way through the clinical trial process, that's where I can see huge data problems and mm-hmm. absolute need to employ techniques like artificial intelligence. And then thirdly, you know, as a benefit of being today a healthy person and having young children, I really look to the future of preventative medicine. With all of the technology we're building in the world today, with digital wearables and the fact that genomics is becoming mainstream, connecting your genetic disposition to what's happening in your everyday life so that we can prevent illness from happening, that's where I see the future.
And then I think lastly, I'm always interested, and I think the audience is always interested, for very, very successful executives like yourself, you know, the career path. You know, you've got a background in engineering and tech. Did you always know that this is something that you wanted to do?
No, I didn't. I really enjoyed math and science in high school. I actually started as an international business student, but as soon as I got into calculus for business, I really started to miss my math roots, and I decided to take a look at electrical engineering because we were in that era of computers. We're going to create new capabilities for all areas of science, engineering, and technology, and I thought, if there's one place I should be, it should be in engineering. And so I chose the electrical engineering path and started my internship in a medical imaging, diagnostic mm-hmm. medical imaging company. And immediately then I realized being able to help people through technology was a real honor to be a part of. If you can't help people directly, if I'm not a trained doctor directly, how could we take this technology and then indirectly affect the care of patients? And so from then on, I just never looked back, and it's just been an honor to be able to start the practice here at NVIDIA.
Well, we really want to thank you for your insights and your participation at our healthcare conference this year. Thank you very much.
Thank you for inviting us and letting us be the first tech company to present. It's been a real honor and a great conference.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you.